Hello everyone. Welcome to the Aloha Cowboy Saloon. So with the holidays here, we thought it would be a nice time to bring you another edition of Cars and Cocktails, where we have friends come over with their old cars, make them a couple drinks at the bar, and chat about the cars. And, you know, episode number one with Troy Harrison did pretty good. I think we got something like 36 views on the YouTube channel, so building on that success, we thought you would like to see another episode. So tonight we have episode number two, Holiday Edition, with Mark and Diane Sachs of Merriam, Kansas. Now, Diane has brought over her very pretty hot rod, and we'll tell you a little bit more about what that is once they get here. And I have come up with two or three yummy holiday cocktails for them to try while we talk about the cars, and they can tell me what they think of those. Sample my amateur bartending skills. So yeah, we'll see how they're doing after two cocktails, and you know, if they want to go ahead with a third, because we do want them to get home in one piece. They do still have to take that car home. So with that, let's go ahead and go get Mark and Diane, and episode number two, Holiday Edition, Cars and Cocktails.
Waiting on our bartender to get here.
Where the hell did she go?
I don't know. She'll be here in a little bit.
I hope she washes her hands when she comes back.
Oh, there she is.
Talking about me? What the hell? Merry Christmas! I can hear you, you know. Well, Merry Christmas. So, yeah, hi everybody again. This is Mark and Diane Sachs, and they have brought over tonight Diane's beautiful 1958 Dodge Coronet, and we're going to chat a little bit about that. But first, we're going to make them a drink, because I do not want people sitting here at the bar without a drink in hand. So let's do that, and then we'll get to chatting. So the drink that we're going to try first is called the Rum Rum Reindeer, and I said it successfully that time.
Yes.
For some reason, it's been a little bit of a tongue twister for me.
That sounded good.
But this looked like a tasty holiday cocktail, and we are making it with Appleton Estate rum. It's got a little bit of orange juice, little Angostura bitters, cream of coconut, and made this earlier today. It's a gingerbread simple syrup. So
that sounds good.
Yeah, I think this is going to be pretty tasty. So we'll get to shaking that up, see how these guys like it.
Applejack smells so good. Nice and frothy.
Yep, exactly. Wash my hands, Mark. Don't worry.
Well, you were gone forever. I didn't know what you were doing.
Check my lipstick. Oh, I'll just put a little shot glass down here. Uh-oh, sorry, Mark.
I'm used to that.
Dang, you got shorted. You know what? We can fix that with a little extra ice. Look at that. Perfection.
Looks okay. Pretty anyway.
Get some garnishes.
Fancy.
Maraschino cherries. Ooh, that's pretty.
Oh, that is pretty.
Hey, but wait. Where's my umbrellas? Oh, here we go.
Purple, my favorite color.
Umbrella for you.
Remove the rubber.
Remove the rubber, please. I tell you, I've never met these people before. Okay, give it away. We'll get you a couple straws.
I need a straw for one. I need a straw.
You don't need a straw? Okay.
It could
okay.
Be a problem.
That one's good.
All three of us approve. That's unusual. So we'll post the recipe for this one for sure.
Oh, yeah.
Good. That's tasty.
That is really good.
Gingerbread simple syrup and the rum. Oh yeah, and there's a little lemon in it.
I can taste that nutmeg.
Really good. Good holiday cocktail. So, now that you have a drink in your hand, let's talk about the car.
Okay.
Other things. So, as I said, Diane has a really gorgeous 1958 Dodge Coronet. And by the way, Diane is also very well known in the pinup community. She is a hot rod honey. And we'll talk a little bit more about that too. But let's talk about the car first. So how long have you had it?
Since 2010, I think.
You think?
I think.
Well.
Because I had the...
You had a decade.
Oh, wait.
Well, we had the...
Truck for a few months. I was working on it.
Okay. Probably 2008. Is it matches my other car.
Yeah.
My 36 International.
What are the specs on it? So, engine size.
It has an LS motor in it. We swapped that out a couple years ago. And it had the original motor in it when we got it. The interior was totally gone out of it when we got it. And had to redo that.
It's pretty now.
Yeah.
It's good now.
And so, we pretty much left the paint, the patina and everything on that is original. And the top's kind of getting a little threadbare on the paint, but I try and keep it waxed pretty good to try and keep. So it's not quite a daily driver, but I do drive it a lot.
You do drive it a lot. Diane and I actually just met for lunch last week, and she's just driving. I mean, you know, the weather was beautiful.
It was
so that
beautiful.
Helps. It's not typical winter weather, but she's just driving it around here and there, popping around town. Oh, I love that. I wish my car were in the kind of condition that it could be pretty much a daily driver from
yeah.
what it to be. So
it's,
we'll get
it's
there.
A lot
we'll get
of
there
fun.
Yeah.
Gets a lot of looks, you know. You
oh, yeah.
just don't see them around much anymore.
Yeah, on this. But have you changed much on it? You know, custom stuff versus its stock?
Yeah, no, we haven't really changed a whole lot on it.
And what, tell me again, I know we've talked about this a little bit, but the custom speed shop, they have some custom logos on the car, custom speed shop, right? And where did that come from?
Actually, from a leather Harley Davidson coat had it on the back of it. And before I built the cars, I built a motorcycle. And I used that coat as the seat covering for that motorcycle. So it just kind of stuck, and then I started working on the truck, doing it, and I just thought, well, I'll drag that onto the door, onto the truck. And then when this showed up, they were kind of paint matched between the truck and the car, and we ended up adding it to that car too. So
it looks cool too. Who did the painting, the pinstriping?
The pinstriping was done by Scott Thomas, and he's a really well-known motorcycle painter. That was his gig. He did a lot of fancy paint for bikes,
yeah.
And he was extremely good at pinstriping. He's way more particular than I am, you know, so when he's doing the pinstripe and he's wiping off a lot, I finally got onto him and said, when you lay it, just leave it, don't touch it. And
didn't want it too perfect.
Yeah, the only that's both sides aren't exactly the same, but they're so close that you really got to be knowing what you're looking for. So
yeah.
He did a great job. I mean, when he made the truck match the car, I think it kind of made all that pop. So.
Yeah, looks great.
Yep.
That's something else we should note is that Diane worked for Harley Davidson for 18 years. Is
yes.
that right? Plant recently, about a year and a half ago, shut down. But
yes.
But you were for Harley Davidson in the custom graphics department.
Yes.
Right?
In the paint department.
And what did you do?
I started out painting the motorcycle parts, actually. And then I advanced over to the what they call the finesse department, where they did all the pinstriping and the decals and all that. So
that's cool.
That was a fun job right there.
Yeah, I bet.
So, and it was a good job to work for, and it was just a shock when they closed.
Yeah. It's a good chunk of your life, 18 years.
Yeah.
So
yeah, it was
rough.
A shock to everybody,
yeah.
But we made do.
Yeah.
With what we had, you know. So they gave us enough time to get all your affairs in order. So
They gave you like 6 months notice or more than that.
18 months.
18 months.
Yeah.
Okay. That's yeah.
Yeah, they gave
that's
us more
good.
Than
that's
enough
good.
Time.
Yeah.
Yeah, and we were working 7 days a week, 12 hours a day, at the end, just trying to get everything
buttoned up.
Yeah. So it was fun.
Drink up those cocktails so we can get on number two. We're almost ready to make number two.
Right.
So what is your number one wish list item for your car right now? Is there anything, any big thing that you'd just love to do to it? Got AC, right?
Yeah, but the AC needs to be worked on.
It needs a stereo.
It does need a stereo.
Proper stereo.
It's got the place for it. It's got a plate in there where you can see where the stereo should go. So that's good. But, I mean, a Bluetooth speaker works just as good, too.
Yeah, that's what I do in my car. Say, it would be nice to get a good stereo that's concealed and sounds great.
Really, the only thing that I can say right now is I'd like a new set of tires on it. But other than that, it rolls down the highway really nice.
You do much work on it yourself, or is that more of a family effort?
We kind of work on it, you know, together. And he knows more than I do, but he's taught me a lot.
That's good.
Yeah, and it's a lot of fun. So
you change your own oil? I can't change my own oil.
I have before, but yeah,
I'm not sure I can change a tire. I hate to say that, but it's true.
I can change a tire.
I could probably, if I was hard pressed too. I've seen it done.
Just gotta shake it, don't stop it. That hard to get a help.
Yes, but that's not what we're talking about. We're talking about doing the work ourselves. Oh, yeah. I mean, that's what I've depended on my whole life. Just kidding. Talking about going outside of my comfort zone.
Smart enough to use it.
Oh, Lordy.
That's what my kids used to say. Mom, he was looking straight at your... You didn't get a
and
ticket.
You're like, I know.
Yeah,
it'll work. I said, whatever works.
Okay, guys, you think you're about ready for drink number two?
Yes.
Oh, I'm ready.
Are we there yet?
The last one was really good.
I'm actually going to make four on this round because I thought me and Kurt maybe could join you.
So, yeah.
Okay, so holiday cocktail number two, Mele Kalikimaka Mai Tai or Christmas Mai Tai. And it has gold rum, dark spiced rum, dark rum, heavy on the rum, a little bit of cranberry juice, pineapple juice, orgeat, which is an almond syrup, simple syrup, bitters, and that's about it. So some nice holiday flavors there. Oh, and a little bit of tiki spices, which has got clove in it. So that's probably kind of what gives it a more holiday feel. So let's shake these up. See what we all think.
If it's anything like the last one, it's gonna be really good.
Yeah, that was a winner.
That was a winner. I'm glad.
that's gonna stay in the cocktail book.
Yes. That one needs a repeat for sure.
The Rum Rum Reindeer. My hands were bigger, I could do two shakers at the same time, and I don't think I can swing it. So we'll just do one. A lot of booze in there.
I know. Hopefully this one's as sweet as the last one. The last one was pretty sweet.
I don't think it's going to be quite as sweet as the last one, but probably still a bit sweet.
Right.
Quite a bit left over. I think I might just.
Oh, wow.
Actually, I guess I could have saved that for you guys.
Wow, that's pretty good. So, actually, you can get almost three drinks out of that.
Yeah. Well, you need a garnish. I did some sugar-coated cranberries for a garnish on this one.
Oh, that's cute.
So pretty. I like that.
That is pretty.
And a couple of cinnamon sticks. Probably just going to fall to the bottom, but that's okay. Okay, wait. Let me shake up this one. All right. Give it a try.
Oh, yeah.
What do we think?
I like that one. It does taste more Christmassy. The flavors.
That's good. It does, yeah. It's not as sweet.
Yeah.
A little more spice.
But it does taste like a Christmas pie.
Wow, I think I might like, yeah, it does. I think I might like that one a little bit better.
Birth of our Lord and Savior.
It might remind me a little bit of a mincemeat pie.
I don't think I've ever had a mincemeat pie.
You had mincemeat pie?
No.
Okay, guys, if you're familiar with mincemeat pie, it's got tiki spices, has the clove, and I don't know. If you wanted to see what I mean, try this. And if you like mincemeat pie, kind of reminds me of that.
This is really good, too. I like the first drink better, but this one is good.
They're both very good.
Yeah.
Yeah, I like them both. This is a little bit more my taste, I guess, but I'll drink crap out of both of them. So talking about things a little bit different than just the car itself, but I've always had a special appreciation and respect for women, and pinups in particular, that have their own car and are part of the culture and not just out there for photos and attention.
The prize money?
Other people's cars. How do you feel about people that just show up for pictures, really only care if there's photographers there, have no real connection to the culture itself, and then just disappear when they're bored with it?
That's kind of a hard question.
I know, it is kind of a hard question. But I don't know, it's something that I think about over the years. And
I think when you own your own car, you have more appreciation and you're more careful around other people's cars. A lot of times I see these women that show up for just the pictures,
right,
and they climb all over the people's cars, or they don't ask permission to take pictures with the cars, or lean up against the cars and scratch them and not give it a second thought.
Rivets on jeans.
Yes.
Things like that.
I myself, I allow my car to be in a lot of pictures.
Me too.
And I have noticed that there's mud dragged through on the carpet. Their feet are rubbing on the side of the door panels, and those door panels are original, and so they get messed up. I've got scratches on my hood because people think they can sit on my hood.
Yeah.
And so yeah, I see a lot of that, but in the most
That's
part,
not okay.
A lot of them are pretty respectful. And if I'm with any, like, say new gals to the new system, you know, and they're just starting out, I'll run them through a lot of that.
Good.
Because I've been doing this since really all my life. I look up, I mean, I'm 60 years old, so a lot of the girls, I kind of am like a mom to them.
Pinup mom?
Yeah, I'm their pinup mom. And so yeah, yeah. I can kind of show them the ways and how they should do it. And a lot of them take that to heart. And they'll pass it on to the other girls that they know, which...
It's good knowledge to have if you're going to be out there,
yes,
running around taking pictures of people's cars. You need to know the etiquette.
Right.
To know. I mean, even just like you said, like getting inside the car, you know, laying across the seat.
Right.
And there's the heels, and it's like, okay, you're being careful, but are you thinking about your feet and where your feet are, you know,
right,
are you thinking about those heels digging into the seats? Like, what do you have to say to all the folks that criticize you for putting yourself out there as a mature pinup model, which is something we have in common?
Right.
Because I know there's a lot of criticism. And, you know, there's those random people out there that think we shouldn't be modeling still, or, you know.
Right.
As long as we want to. As long as our hearts desire.
Right.
So what do you have to say to those people?
I don't think pinup has an age.
Or modeling in general.
Or modeling in general, right. I am all for whatever age you are. I don't care if you're skinny, if you're curvy. Any shape and size is pinup material. I hear so many times that people are like, oh, I'm not the right size. Let me lose weight. And it's like, you're
all
beautiful
sizes.
The way
yes.
you are. Just rock it. And I do have an issue with me going gray, but I am 60 years old, and I'm just rocking it the way I am. And my motto is, if you don't like it, I'm not gonna push myself on you. you right. know, but I'm here.
But you have the option to go the right. other direction, too. You know?
Right, and walk on by. I am a grandmother, so if you want to tell me, criticize me by saying you're too old, you're a grandma, yes, I am a grandma, but I love being a grandma. And so,
I know, like, thank you.
You know, it's grandma. Kind of a compliment to me because I just love the pinups, and even the younger gals, they don't treat me like I'm old. I mean, everybody's on the same level. And so it's just the fun that we all have together. It's a sisterhood.
Yeah.
I saw.
Cheers, honey. Cheers, Hot Rod, honey.
Thank you, Birdie Birdie. I love meeting new people, and I love making new friends, and it's a large sisterhood that, you know, we just seem to thrive in. And if you're having a bad day, you can always get a hold of one of your pinup sisters, and they can always change your mood.
Yeah.
And you can have, you know, a good time, and that's what I like. I just like the coming together. Everybody supports each other, and you know, it's just awesome.
They're all each other's cheerleaders.
Yes,
for the most part. Right. Hot Rod Honey has been published a lot, both with and without her car. But what magazines and publications have you been in with or without your car?
Good luck with that.
Well, okay.
I've been
a lot.
Garters and Grills, Galaxy 57. You would ask me. It's
Lovely.
I can't remember all the
names.
There's just too many to.
Oh, you've been in. Oh shoot, I was in it too. Oh, the one out of the UK. Bombshell. Yeah, you've been in Bombshell.
Yes. So yeah, I've been published international and in the United States. So, it's a lot of fun, and yes, I take a lot of pictures. Not all of them get published. But it's just a lot of fun.
But you don't try for all of them either.
No, I don't. Yeah. But just looking at yourself in a magazine in itself is like, hey, I did that. Mm-hmm. You know, and I'm a lot older than a lot of the other girls, but everybody, yeah, everybody accepts me for who I am, not for my age. So it's a lot of fun.
Anything upcoming? As far as magazines, publications,
not right now. You know, with the COVID this year, I haven't really got to do a whole lot of photo shoots.
Yeah.
So that kind of slowed up on submitting any.
No car shows.
Yeah, no car shows and submitting any submissions to any magazines right now. So I'm hoping 2021 will be better.
Well, we all hope that. I'm not super optimistic that it will happen that soon, but maybe 2022.
Right.
I've got some mistletoe here. Just thought I'd point it out.
And I like that it has the diamond on it.
It is mistletoe.
I need one that big right there.
I put it here just for this occasion.
You wouldn't wear it.
Aw, Merry Christmas, guys.
Thank you. Merry Christmas to you.
Hey, babe, there's a mistletoe over here. Did you hear me talk about this mistletoe?
I don't want to pass that up.
I finally get a kiss.
Mark,
all the other 100 mil.
Where are you going, Mark?
Give him a kiss.
It's time for me to actually get a goddamn kiss.
Well, guys. You can find and follow Diane on her public Facebook page as well as her Instagram page, Hot Rod Honey. Oh, and you know, maybe if we're lucky, we can get Mark and Diane to come back for another episode in the future with their Rat Rod.
Absolutely. Ooh, that would be fun.
Think about that.
Yeah.
Maybe in the springtime.
Yeah.
Take a little cruise in it.
There you go.
That would be fun.
Well, thanks for coming, you guys. I really appreciate it. I hope you like the cocktails. We will probably have a third cocktail. Is this number two or three? This is number two. So we'll probably do a third cocktail off camera. But thanks for joining us, guys, for the holiday edition of Cars and Cocktails.
Bye.
Merry Christmas.
Aloha.